evening. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Papago Park. Todd Garbison for Southwest Sports Network. It's play-by-play coverage in Southwest Woodbat Classics tournaments. It's the 2017 MLK Classic. And we are underway in an upper-class division championship game. It features Blue Chip Navy against the Nogales Tribe. And Blue Chip Navy, the visitors in this one, their leadoff hitter, Alex Kennert, with a pop-up into foul territory that is caught for out number one. Blue Chip Navy in this championship game by way of winning the red pool, where they went 3-0. And for Nogales Tribe, winners out of the white pool, they went 3-1 in their pool play. The ball foul to the backstop. Bradley Mente, the second hitter, starting in center field today. So he bats with one out of the bases empty. Tanner Solomon bats third. He's today's starting pitcher for Blue Chip Navy. Gage Kenny will bat fourth. Jake Stein, the shortstop, fifth. And a ground ball rolled out to short, picked up, and a throw wide at first base. And runner's going to try for second. The throw got there in time, but short hopped the Nogales second baseman. It goes into left field. So Mante aboard at second base with one out for Tanner Solomon. That'll go as a two-base throwing error, so an E6. And now Solomon will try to move him around. First pitch over the outside corner, a strike. I mentioned Kenny fourth, Stein fifth. Kieran Kokora bats sixth and plays first base. Jared Costello starts in right field and bats seventh. Austin George, the catcher, eighth. Cade Lautenschlager, that's ninth, as it pitches a strike. And Lautenschlager starts at third base. Ryan Johnson, the second baseman, 10th. Kyle Ferentz starts in left field and bats 11th. Check back, and the pitch out away. Ball one, 1-2. Gerardo Martinez, the starter for Nogales. Turn and a throw back to second, but the runner dives back. Serge Gonzalez starts in left field for Nogales. Marcel Bachelor in center field. And Ralph Padilla starts in right. Breaking ball hit on the ground over toward the second baseman. And a throw on to first is in time. Solomon grounds out 4-3 for out number two. Mente goes to second base. I make it from second to third, and the batter is Gage Kenny. The infield then for Nogales, Chuy Lopez starts at third base. Kevin Jimenez, the shortstop. Jorge Bojorquez, the second baseman. Alec Acevedo at first. Jara Lopez behind the plate. The ball fouled out of play. So that is strike one. Two outs and a runner at third. Just getting settled in here in the top of the first inning. Now Martinez steps off. And a breaking ball over for a strike, and it's 0-2. Runner with the leadoff, third base. And Martinez with a pitch, and that's fouled off. breaking ball misses up and in. Ball one, 1-2. And 2 balls and 2 strikes. And the 2-2 is high, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Kenny trying to get that runner in from third base for Blue Chip Navy here in the top of the first. Martinez looking in, Lopez through the signs, and now the 3-2. And that's high, ball 4. Error and now a walk in the inning. 2 runners aboard with 2 outs for Jake Stein. First pitch high, ball 1. This game was scheduled for a 1:30 start. And the game prior to this one was an underclass division championship game. Didn't really run long. It was done by about 1:15. And yet we didn't get this one started till 1:59. Pitch high, 2-0. And that sometimes has to do with the umpires as far as maybe they're swapping fields or even just swapping positions. Maybe the base umpire has to put the gear on to work behind the plate and vice versa. So anyway, got going a little bit late. We'll see how this one progresses. Pitch high, 3-0. Foul out started the ball game, then an E6, in fact a 2-base throwing error on an E6, and a ground out moved the runner from second to third, and then a walk. So we got first and third with 2 outs. 3-0 on Stein with Kieran Kokora next. And hit on a 3-0 pitch is Stein, so he'll move to first base. That'll push Kenny to second and loads the bases. Loads the bases for Blue Chip Navy for Kieran Kokora. First pitch to Kokora over for a strike.
They want the ball.
Yeah, Martinez back to it, the 0-1. And a breaking ball, that one's over for a strike. He's thrown that pitch a couple of times and left it up. This time gets to the top of the strike zone and jumps ahead of Kokora, nothing in two.
Here we go, block it. Got a kid.
Pitch inside, 1 ball and 2 strikes. Now Lopez goes through the signs. Here's Martinez into the wind of the 1-2. They got a fastball fouled out of play. Martinez, another 1-2 pitch and a breaking ball. That one just misses. 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Hey, that was great.
Two.
2-2. 2-2.
That question on the count, 2-2 is what I had. That's what the plate umpire had, so that's what we'll go with. There was a question from Blue Chip Navy. I think really just the hitter, Kakura, thought it might have been 3-2. And a ground ball foul outside of third base, and we'll try it again. And hit third, Kenny at second, Stein at first. And another 2-2, and it's fouled back out of play. That one just about straight back behind us. So Kakura's fouled off three different two-strike pitches, and pitch number 8 of the at-bat coming up here from Gerardo Martinez.
Hey, you got this, kiddo.
And on the outside corner with a fastball, a called third strike. And Blue Chip Navy turned away in the first inning. No runs, no hits, an error, a walk, and a hit batter. They leave 3 aboard after having a play. Blue Chip Navy nothing. Nogales coming up. Kevin Jimenez, the leadoff hitter for Nogales in the bottom of the first inning, takes a fastball for a strike from Tanner Solomon as we get underway in the bottom of the first. And now the 0-1. This is high and away. 1-1. So Jimenez, the shortstop, leads off for the Tribe. Marcel Bachelier will bat second and play center field. Ralph Padilla, the right fielder, bats third. Ball fouled to the backstop in the count 1-2. Hitting in the cleanup spot for Nogales, Alec Acevedo starting at first base. Then Serge Gonzalez bats fifth and plays left field. Chuy Lopez starts at third base and bats sixth. As the 1-2 pitch is on the way. Check swing and able to hold up is Jimenez in the count 2-2. Batting at seventh in the order for Nogales, the second baseman, Jorge Bojorquez. Then Jara Lopez bats eighth and works behind the plate. Ricky Maturana is an extra hitter along with Diego Favela. 3-2 on Jimenez. And a fastball misses away, ball 4. So Jimenez walks to get things started in the bottom of the first. First pitch fastball outside, ball 1. Pretty good lead over there at first, and throw goes that way, and the runner back. And Solomon's pitch off the plate, 2-0. First, and again the runner back. Blue Chip Navy low to the bases in the top of the first inning but could not score. And now Nogales with the leadoff hitter aboard. Fastball on the inside corner, a strike, 2-1. And the 2-1 pitch. Healthy cut there. The count goes to 2-2.
Open up now. Here you go.
That pitch down in the dirt, blocked, and as the runner takes off, throw goes to second base late. So a wild pitch moves Jimenez to second. 3-2 count to the number two hitter, the Nogales sorter. And a swing and a miss. So strike three, and that's out number one in the Nogales first inning. It'll bring up Ralph Padilla. Salomon with a look back to second, and the first pitch off the plate, ball one. And next pitch, low and away. Now Solomon has gone full of the first two hitters. 3-2 walk to Jimenez, 3-2 strikeout to Batchelier. And that ball hits down the left field line. If it's a fair ball, it's trouble. It is down for a base hit. Runner will come around third base and scores. The throw gets back in. It's an RBI double for Ralph Padilla, and Nogales leads 1-0. So the leadoff walk hurts Solomon and Blue Chip as Jimenez walked, went to second on a wild pitch, and scores on the double from Padilla. And now the batter is Alec Acevedo. And Acevedo delivers a shot into left field. And they're going to send that runner around. Here comes the relay throw to the plate. Not in time. Nogales forces the issue there, puts a little pressure on, and Padilla scores on the RBI single from Alec Acevedo. And it's 2-0 Tribe. Serge Gonzalez. The 1-0-2 Gonzalez with the runner going, a hit and run, it looked like, as that fastball got in on the hands, fouled off, and they count 1-1. Throw to first and the runner back. Pitch bounced in, 2-1 on Gonzalez. Chuy Lopez next for Nogales. High pop up, actually a little deeper. Fly ball into left field. The runner took off, but got stopped soon enough there, and back to first base he goes. So Gonzalez with a fly ball to Ferentz in left field for out number two. Now Chuy Lopez with Acevedo still at first. Two runs in for Nogales in the bottom of the first inning. They lead Blue Chip Navy 2-0. Pitch fastball outside, ball one. Again, a throw to first, and again the runner back. Salomon ready again, and the pitch. A balk is called. And Acevedo goes to second base. We'll get a timeout from the blue chip dugout. Playing in the bottom of the first, 2-0 Nogales. And after the timeout, Lopez lifts a high fly ball into right field. And right near the line and in foul territory, Jared Costello makes the catch, and that will end the inning. But Nogales on the board first. They get a couple of runs on two hits. They leave one, and after an inning of play, Nogales 2, blue chip nothing. Jared Costello leads out, goes after the first pitch, and lifts a pop-up into shallow right field. It's the second baseman, Bohorquez, out on the grass to make the catch. One pitch and one out. Decent communication out there. Bohorquez going out and Padilla, the right fielder, coming in. Typically, you say an outfielder calls off an infielder, but Bohorquez stayed with that there. They avoided any collision and got the first out. Now, Austin George with a swing and a miss for a strike. The 0-1 pitch misses low. One ball and one strike. One out, and the base is empty here in the top of the second. The next pitch low, and a count 2-1. Now the 2-1 to Austin George, and a pop-up, and this will get over the backstop and out of play. So 2-2 on George. Kate Lautenschlager next for Blue Chip Navy in the 2-2 pitch. And I'll ring him up. Called third strike. Schlager takes low, ball one. 2 outs and the base is empty in the top of the second. Blue Chip Navy trailing Nogales 2-0. The 1-0, and a tapper off the plate or near that hard-packed ground near the plate, and count goes to 1-1. Ryan Johnson next for Blue Chip Navy. Next one low and away, 2 balls and 1 strike. Blue Chip Navy loaded the bases in the top of the first inning but could not score. Did it without a base hit, an error, a walk, and a hit batter. And 3 balls and a strike. And the 3-1. Pop up, and again back behind the backstop, out of play, and it's 3-2. And in on the handle, foul, out of play again. We'll stay 3-2. Another 3-2 from Martinez. And another foul ball from Lautenschlager. swing and a miss, pulled the string there, and it's back-to-back strikeouts to end the top of the second inning. 3-up, 3-down go Blue Chip Navy in the second. After an inning and a half, they trail Nogales 2-0. Bohorquez leads out for Nogales in the bottom of the second. Lopez and Maturana follow. The 1-0 pitch, low, 2-0. And the 2-0 pitch over four strike. It's 2-1. And Solomon, the 2-1 pitch. And a ground ball out to short. Good job to stay down there. And a throw low, though, and not able to pick it up at first base is Kokora. That'll be an E6. Thought Stein might have had trouble with the ground ball, but did a nice job to stay with it and then threw low over to first, and Kokora couldn't pick it out. Borges aboard at first base for Hera Lopez. With a swing and a miss, strike one. Easy toss over to first, and the runner gets back. A couple of runs for Nogales in the bottom of the first inning, and now the first man aboard in the second. Pitch at the knees, a strike, and it's 0-2.
Here you go. Open up.
Fastball high, one ball and two strikes. Pitch inside, 2-2. George through the sign, Solomon ready, and the 2-2. Bounced in, and the runner's going to take off as the throw to second base is tardy. Gets to second on a wild pitch. 3-2, they count on Hera Lopez. And that ball crushed into left field and over the head of the left fielder. It'll go all the way to the warning track. It's going to slow down, actually, that thick outfield grass. Still, though, going to be an RBI double, and it's 3-0 Nogales. Mario Duarte will run at second as the courtesy runner for the catcher, Lopez. Ricky Maturana will bat. And Maturana trying to bunt. Bunts foul for strike one. An unearned run for Nogales here in the second inning. This is inside, and they count 1-1. And And a fastball fouled off. And they count 1-2. And the 1-2 pitch. And breaking ball fought off. Ground ball moves that runner from second to third. Four, three ground out retires Mantarena. And now runner at third with one out and a run in for Nogales in the bottom of the second. Favela at the plate with an infield drawn in, takes a breaking ball for strike one. The one strike pitch from Solomon misses inside, and they count 1-1. One pitch. Swing and a miss. It's 1-2. And a breaking ball bounced in. That'll go to the backstop, and that'll bring in another run. Lopez, courtesy runner. Duarte scores on a wild pitch. And it's a 4-0 Tribe. I'll try to get it started again here. 2-2 count. And a swing and a miss. That's strike three. And that's out number two. Second out of the inning. Second strikeout of the ball game for Tanner Solomon. Go back to the top of the order for Kevin Jimenez. Jimenez walked and scored in the first. And a ground ball through the hole on the right side and into right field, a base hit. So Jimenez aboard for the second time in as many trips. Now Marcel Bachelier. First pitch over the outside corner, strike one. Throw to first and the runner back. Gallus follows up the two-run first inning with a two-run second. Couple of throws to first, but just trying to keep him in his close. He went to a second on a wild pitch back in the first inning and then scored on Ralph Padilla's RBI double. The ball fouled out of play down the left side, and it's nothing and two. Punched into left field, down for a base hit, and it just trickles past the left fielder as Ference wasn't able to get it clean, and that maybe allowed an extra base. I don't know that he got enough of it to make it an error. It looked that way, the way the play unfolded there. But either way, it's another base hit, and runners now at first make it second and third. So I think that probably will go as a single and then an E7. Runners at second and third with two outs for Ralph Padilla. And the pitch is high, ball one. Padilla with an RBI double his first time up. So Nogales thinking the right guy at the right time here. Number three hitter in the order with a chance to drive in a couple of more runs. Fastball off the plate and the count 2-0. And a fly ball into center field, but that'll hang up there long enough, and it's tracked down in center field to end the inning. A loud final out in the Nogales second, but as it is, the Tribe score 200 runs. And they do it on three hits, two errors committed in the inning, and two runners left on base. Two innings in the books from Papago Park. Nogales leads Blue Chip Navy by a score of 4-0. Ten, 11, and 1 in the order for Blue Chip Navy in the top of the third. Ryan Johnson takes ball one. And then it hits a ball pretty well out to right center field. That's going to split the outfielders. And Johnson coming around second will try for third base, and he'll be in without a throw. A leadoff triple for Blue Chip Navy in the top of the third. Kyle Ference, the left fielder for Blue Chip Navy, will be the first one to try to get that runner in from third base. Yeah, first pitch low and away for ball one. Now for a moment there, the Nogales middle infielders were in on the grass. Coaches quickly move them back. They'll trade the run for the out. Check swing and a ground ball back to the pitcher Martinez. And that won't get the run home. A 1-3 ground out retires Ference for out number one. Now Alex Kennard back at the top of the order for Blue Chip Navy. I mentioned they were the winners of the red pool. Blue Chip Navy went 3-0 through pool play. First pitch low and away, ball one. For Blue Chip Navy, they beat Evan Pressure Baseball White 9-5. They beat the Wolves 5-4. And then beat the Tucson Hawks 7-1. There's a line shot past the shortstop Jimenez. That's into left field for a base hit. Blue Chip Navy on the board for the first time. They get a run in the top of the third. RBI single from Alex Kennard cuts the deficit to 4-1. First pitch over for a strike. And a breaking ball off the end of the bat. And they'll call the batter out. The second baseman, Bajorquez, trying to drop that ball on purpose there to maybe turn that into a double play, but instead it is called an out by the base umpire. So it's a pop out to the second baseman, Bajorquez, for out number two. Kennard stays put at first base, and the batter, Tanner Solomon. Solomon takes high for ball one. It's not a bad idea. I don't know if Bajorquez thought of it right at the last second. Got to act a little bit better on that one, but the idea is that runner at first base is going to stay sort of tight to the bag on a pop-up like that. Obviously not wanting to get doubled up as a breaking ball misses outside on its 2-0. And so the idea then is you drop it late, you get a chance to get the lead runner, which, again, traditional baseball says your leadoff hitter is going to be one of your faster guys, and so you get the leadoff guy off the bases, swap him out for the number two hitter. There's another pop-up. Borges will get another chance, and instead it'll be the first baseman, Acevedo, and he makes the catch to end the inning. Blue Chip Navy on the board after a leadoff triple from Ryan Johnson, an RBI single from Alex Kennard. They end up with two hits in the inning, and they leave one aboard. After 2.5, Blue Chip Navy trailing Nogales by a score of 4-1. Alec Acevedo, leadoff hitter for Nogales in the bottom of the third. Acevedo Gonzalez Lopez for the Tribe. Breaking ball low and away. And the next pitch inside, and it's 3-0. Acevedo with an RBI single, his first time up. Pitch over for a strike, and it's 3-1. Now swing and a miss, and it's 3-2. Pitch low for ball four. Solomon fell behind 3-0, got a couple of strikes, but then missed low for the ball and sends Acevedo to first base to start the Nogales third inning. Here's Serge Gonzalez. Is outside for ball one. We had some sunshine in the earlier game. We did the 11-15 underclass championship game today and had sun throughout a lot of that one. Fastball for a strike. Runs the count to 1-1. But it's been mostly cloudy throughout much of this one, and that drops the temperature for sure. The 1-1, way outside. George got just a piece of it with a glove to slow it down, and that kept Acevedo from trying to advance. The next pitch misses outside. Three balls and a strike on Gonzalez. Acevedo aboard at first base. So we play in the bottom of the third inning. Nogales leading Blue Chip by a score of 4-1. And a pitch at the knees for a strike, and it's 3-2. Runner takes off on 3-2, and it's a high pop-up in the infield. Going to have to hurry to get back. And no throw back to first base as the Pop fly is hauled in by Ryan Johnson, the second baseman. Now Chuy Lopez. Lopez with a swing and a miss for strike one. And that pitch over for a strike, and it's 0-2. Lopez with a fly ball to right field to end the first inning. Bounced in, knocked down, and the throw to second base high and safe to call. So a wild pitch moves Acevedo to second. Tamper to Solomon, who does a 360 as he looked over at that runner, but Acevedo got a good jump and took off. So a 1-3 ground out is out number two, but Acevedo goes to third base, and Bohorquez will try to knock him in. Strike. Nice one high in the count 2-1. Over for a strike, and it's 2-2. Pop up over on the first base side, and that's the second baseman Johnson there to make the catch. And the inning is over. First time in the ball game that Nogales fails to score. They got a leadoff walk in the inning, but left the runner at third base. After three, they still lead 4-1. Gage Kenny going after the first pitch. Lifts it into shallow left center field. And a long run out there, but hauled in for out number one. Chillier brings that one in, and now the batter is Jake Stein. First pitch of strike to Stein. One bounced in, one ball and one strike. Stein hit by a pitch his first time up. And that pitch fouled off, and they count 1-2. The 1-2. Ground ball foul outside third base. the 1-2, and that's a fly ball hit well out to left field. That'll be a long run out there, and a diving try, but the ball's down, and that'll be extra bases. And in fact, it'll be a triple. Stein slides in ahead of the tag. I think that was Mantarena out there in left field. Did everything he could. I mean, he was positioned where they wanted him to be, but then that ball was hit so well and so far over his head, he had to try to hurry to get back there. Made a nice effort, but couldn't bring it in. Now Kieran Kokura trying to get that runner in from third base. A swing and a miss, strike one. Another swing and a miss, and it's 0-2. Big breaking ball hit on the ground. Runner will head for the plate, and the throw goes on to first base then. It is an RBI ground out for Kokura. 6-3 on the ground out, brings in Stein. Jimenez throws out Kokura at first base, but the run in to cut the deficit to 4-2. And now Jared Costello will start it with two outs and the bases empty. Yeah, first pitch over for strike. Another ground ball and do or die play, and Jimenez not able to bring that one in. Costello aboard. I think it's Kennard that's on to run at first base. I don't know if he was substituted for at some point. I'm not sure if he's the right guy to be in there as a runner. And now the batter is Austin George, who takes high for ball one. For a strike. Throw over to first and the runner back. Fouled to the backstop. And a swing and a miss. And the ball gets away, though, and the runner will reach base safely, or the batter will. So it goes as a strikeout and a wild pitch. Costello to second, actually a courtesy runner, and then George comes off for another courtesy runner. So two aboard with two outs, and it's Cade Lautenschlager at the plate. So the tying runs aboard here as we play in the top of the fourth inning. Blue chip down 4-2. First pitch inside, ball one. And the next pitch over for a strike, and it's 1-1. Martinez with the pitch. A breaking ball, low and away, and that's stopped by Lopez. Two and two on Lautenschlager. Two outs, two on, a run in for Blue Chip Navy. They trail 4-2. And that's called a ball. 3-2. Lopez thought he had it as he was on his way to the dugout. Will take off on a 3-2 pitch. High pop up on the left side. Lopez, Jimenez. It'll be the shortstop Jimenez to make the catch. And that will end the inning. Blue Chip Navy adds another run, and after 3.5, trail 4-2. Lopez, the leadoff hitter for Nogales in the bottom of the fourth, facing a new blue chip pitcher. It's Jared Costello. So that's why he was there. That's why they allowed Blue Chip Navy to run for him when he hit in the top of the fourth inning. Pitch over for a strike and the count 2-1. Lopez, Maturana, Favela for Nogales in the bottom of the fourth. Pitch low and away, and it's 3-1. Now, three balls and two strikes. So the line for Tanner Solomon for Blue Chip Navy, their starting pitcher. He's in line for the loss unless Blue Chip can come back over this second half of the ball game, but Solomon goes three innings, allows five hits, four runs, two earned. As Lopez fishes a little bit there, pitch off the plate and strikes out. But five hits, four runs, two of those earned. So he gave up two earned runs in the first, two unearned runs in the second. He walked two and struck out two. Yeah, Maturana. Grounded out his first time up. And Random falls behind in the count. Grounds one foul. For Nogales, they ended up in a pool with five teams, so they played four games in pool play. Another one fouled off. They beat Wildfire 18U 7-1. They beat Westwood 4-0. They beat Blue Chip White 8-0. And then lost to Nutty Buddy 9-1. And there's a ground ball rolled slowly to the second baseman. Throw on to first, not in time. And I don't know what would have been in time, but did get away over there at first base. So I think that'll be an infield single. And now one on and one out.
Come on, Mike.
Pinch hitter for Nogales as Mikey Gerardo bats for the first time. Takes low it in for ball one. So Gerardo bats for the first time here with one on and one out for Nogales in the bottom of the fourth inning. They lead 4-2. Next one inside, and it's 2-0. Low, 3-0. And a pitch over for a strike, and it's 3-1. And that'll miss low, 4. Costello not able to get the pinch hitter as Mantorena goes to second. Gerardo to first, and the batter is Kevin Jimenez. First pitch over for a strike to Jimenez, who walked in the first, singled in the second. Pitch misses for a ball on the count 1-1. 2 runs in the first, 2 runs in the second for Nogales. Blue Chip Navy single runs in the first, in the third rather, and then the fourth. Into a foul territory and put away by Ryan Johnson, who's moved from second base to third. Now Costello with a chance to get out of the inning unscathed. Two aboard with 2 outs. Marcel Bachelier, the batter, and that's off the glove of the catcher, and that'll move the runners up a base each. So now a pair of runners in scoring position for Nogales. A chance to push that lead right back up to 4 again. Ground ball foul outside of first base, and they count 1-1. Pitch inside. Ball fouled off. That one just about up in the eyes there. Two balls, 2 strikes. Ralph Padilla next for the Tribe. The 2-2. And that's a fly ball hit well out to right field. Long run and not going to be able to track it down. Goes as an RBI, make it a two-run double Bachelier as Mantarena scores and Gerardo scores. And the lead is bumped back up to 4. 6-2 now. Nogales with the lead. I think that's Brandon Peterson that was out there in right field, and he didn't really have a chance again based on where the coaches had him playing. Just not a chance to get that one, so he had to hustle to try to track it down and get it back in as quickly as he could. Two balls and no strikes now on Padilla. And now 3-0. Yeah, that misses for ball 4, and time called from the blue chip dugout. Playing in the bottom of the 4th inning now, 6-2, Nogales. First one to Alec Acevedo, misses for ball 1. Fastball strike, throw down to first base, and the runner back. And there's a swing and a miss, but that's off the glove. The runners will move up. Goes a pass ball. 1-2 on Acevedo, but now a pair in scoring position. And a breaking ball bounced in. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Ground ball over to third, off the glove of Lautenschlager, and no play. Then I'll play it another run. It'll go as a tough E5. And another run in. That's 3 in the inning. And the lead is now 7-2. Padilla went to third on the play as well. So Acevedo at first and Padilla at third. Serge Gonzalez takes low ball 1. Now 2 balls and 0 strikes. Called strike there, runs it to 2-1. I would guess that this might be the last hitter either way for Costello. Either he gets the final out of the inning or he might be pulled. We'll see. It looks as though Blue Chip's got another pitcher ready to go over in their bullpen, or over in their dugout, rather. Pitch over for a strike, and it's 3-2. A 3-2, and that misses for ball 4. Gonzalez walks, Acevedo to second. And the batter will be Chuy Lopez. So it wasn't a pitcher that was ready, it was just a defensive change, as Kyle Ferentz is now in at first base. Kokora comes off. You got to figure that somebody in that dugout's going to go get loose here as a pitch is over for a strike to Chuy Lopez. Cora and Kenny both walking over to the bullpen. For Blue Chip Navy, 1-1 the count on Lopez. Bases loaded, 2 outs in the inning. And a healthy hack there, and the count goes to 1-2. It's a 3-run inning for Nogales. They lead 7-2. And a high pop-up. Farron's going to get a chance, just put out there as a new first baseman, and he stays with it to put it away in foul territory, and that will end the inning for Nogales in the bottom of the fourth. They score 3 times, and after 4, lead 7-2. And Ryan Johnson leads off for the second time in 3 innings. Led off the third with a triple and scored the first run of the game for Blue Chip Navy. Lifts a fly ball into right field this time, but it's playable. And it's put away for out number one. Cameron Yates bats in place of Kyle Ferentz. And a hard shot, but fielded by the shortstop Jimenez onto Acevedo at first. And that's out number two, so 2 pitches, 2 outs. And back to the top of the order for Alex Kennert. First one to Kennert, low for a ball. And an RBI single his last time up, 1-for-2 in the day. And the next pitch low, and it's 2-0. Fouled off, they count 2-1. Top of the fifth inning, Blue Chip Navy trailing 7-2. Pitch low and away, and it's 3-1. Fly ball out to left field, and that is caught, and that's the final out. Another 3-up, 3-down inning, and after 4.5, the score remains 7-2. Jorge Bojorquez leads off. The first pitch for a ball, next one over for a strike, and they count 1-1. And a line drive, and that's going to get past the left fielder and go just about to the warning track. Valarquez will pull into second base. He's got a leadoff double. And time called from the Blue Chip dugout. Now we'll get that pitching change. Playing in the bottom of the fifth, 7-2 our score. Aaron Kokora on to pinch for Blue Chip Navy, and this first one to Harold Lopez misses low and away, ball one. And a pop-up on the left side is the shortstop. Right on the outfield grass, makes the catch, and that's out number one. Ricky Mantorana. First pitch low and away and blocked. Tiki Borges at second base. For a strike, and they count 1-1. 7-2 the score as we play in the bottom of the fifth inning. It's the upperclass division championship game of the 2017 MLK Classic. Ball fouled out of play right side, and they count 1-2. Breaking ball, had to wait on it, but drive it into a shallow left center field, and that's down for a base hit. Mantorano with a base hit, his second of the game, 2-for-3 now. And with the Bohorquez having to stay put at second base, it puts him at first and second with one out. And we're back to Diego Favela. First pitch over for a strike. Breaking ball, low and away. They count 1-1. Another breaking ball, now two balls and a strike. Another one misses outside, 3-1. Solomon went the first three innings. Jared Costello pitched through the fourth and the first hitter of the fifth, so he's still responsible for Bohorquez out at second, who now moves to third because of the ball four to Favela. So it's Bohorquez at third, Mantorana at second, Favela at first. Turn the order over again for Nogales, and the batter is Kevin Jimenez. First pitch high for ball one. And a fly ball hit well out to right field. Back there to track it is Kenny. Runners from second and third will each tag. So Bohorquez scores. Jimenez with a sacrifice fly to right field. That's out number two. But to give Jimenez the RBI as again Bohorquez scores. Mantorana to second. So the runners are at the corners. Now two outs in the inning, but another run in. And Nogales now leads Blue Chip Navy 8-2. First pitch over for a strike. Actually here the number two hitter in the order, 2-for-3 on the day. Had a big double his last time up. Pitch is low and they count 1-1. And that ball hit down the right field line. That's a fair ball. Another run will score. Throw will go into second base. And it's not in time. RBI double for Pancheliera's third hit of the game. And another run in. Score now 9-2. First pitch to Ralph Padilla over for a strike. One ball and one strike. Pitch inside, two balls and a strike. Now 3-1 on Padilla. Alec Acevedo next for Nogales. Is inside for ball four. Padilla walks for the second time to go along with a base hit. So the base is full for Acevedo. 1-for-2 plus a walk in 3 plate appearances. Takes the first pitch for strike one. Nogales leads Blue Chip Navy 9-2. And a breaking ball. Well, one ball and one strike. It's the Upperclass Division Championship game, 2017 MLK Classic. And a ground ball over to third. Oh, just about threw that one across the diamond. Instead, tap of the bag at third, the easy play, and that will end the inning. It's an inning fielder's choice off the bat of Acevedo, but a couple of more runs in for Nogales, and after 5 innings of play, they lead Blue Chip Navy 9-2. And we go to work in the top of the 6th inning, 2, 3, and 4 in the order. Bradley Mente takes low and away ball one, and a new pitcher out there, Marcel Bachelier, comes in from center field to take over from Gerardo Martinez, who goes 5 innings. Ball goes to the backstop, 2-0 the count. Martinez, 5 innings of work for the Nogales Tribe, allows 4 hits. 2 runs both earned. Now 3 balls and no strikes. The rest of Martinez's line then 4 strikeouts, 1 walk, 1 hit batter. Pitch over for a strike and it's 3-1. And the 3-1 misses inside, ball 4. A leadoff walk for Blue Chip Navy here in the 6th inning. And the batter, Tanner Solomon. And Solomon goes after the first one and shoves that one into left center field. Runner will take a turn around second, but stop there. And so Blue Chip Navy trying to make a little noise here in the sixth inning. First two men aboard. And the batter is Gage Kenny. Fastball inside for ball one as we get back to play. And that pitch misses outside. Two balls and no strikes. Kenny with a walk in the first, a fly ball to center field in the fourth. Fastball inside, 3-0. Kenny taking all the way here, and he takes strike one. The count goes to 3-1. Blue Chip with single runs in the third and the fourth. Nogales has scored in every inning but the third. And it's been a crooked number in each of those four innings. High pop up on the right side, and it'll drop. They'll throw to second base and get the out there on the force. So it's not a base hit then. It goes as a fielder's choice for Kenny as Solomon is forced at second base for the first out. And it goes to third. So they're at the corners with one out for Jake Stein. Stein tripled and scored his last time up. And takes low, ball one. 9-2 our score as we play in the top of the sixth. And a fastball. Maybe overthrown there. And the count goes to 2-0. Stein climbs back in. Check of the runner at first base, and the pitch is high, 3-0. Fastball misses, a four-pitch walk sends Stein to first, and that loads the bases. Before Kokora can bat, we get a timeout out of the Nogales dugout. Playing in the top of the sixth, it's 9-2. And we get to play here, and Kokora with a swing and a miss for strike one. Bases loaded, one out in the top of the sixth. Back pick over to first base, and runner back. Acevedo tried to sneak in behind Stein there. Deep breath and the one strike pitch. It's fouled off and it's 0-2. Cora with an RBI ground out his last time up after a strikeout in the first inning, 0-2. But a chance to do damage here, can't do it. Swing and a miss, and that is strike three. Out number two in the inning, and the batter is Jared Costello. First pitch fouled out of play on the right side. And that ball will go to the backstop and all the runners move up. So wild pitch brings in a run to make it 9-3. Costello 1-for-2 after a single in the fourth. Fly ball down the line in right field into foul territory and a running catch. And that is put away to end the inning as Blue Chip Navy gets a run in the top of the sixth inning. They get a run on just one hit. And they leave a couple of runners on base. And looks like that's going to do it here as we have hit the time limit. We play 5.5 innings, and Blue Chip Navy falls to Nogales by a final score of 9-3. And so that will do it as the Nogales Tribe victorious in this championship game, and they take home the championship in the upper class division of the 2017 MLK Classic. So that'll do it again. Our final score, it's Nogales 9 and Blue Chip Navy 3. From Papago Park, Todd Garbison for Southwest Sports Network saying so long, and we hope to talk to you again soon.